Unlock the power of secure data storage with Keychain Vault, my keychain management library. Say goodbye to the hassle of dealing with complex keychain APIs and enjoy the simplicity of my user-friendly solution. With this library, you can effortlessly set and retrieve values of any type, making data management a breeze. Whether you're a seasoned developer or just starting with SwiftUI, my handy property wrappers will streamline your code, saving you time and effort. Secure your app-sensitive information with confidence and ease. Invest in Keychain Vault today and take your iOS development to the next level. Mastering the Keychain API is quite hard. Therefore, I have created Keychain Vault. Go ahead and check it out. It's a store.rebeloper.com/keychain-vault. And today I'm going to show you how easy it is to work with it. It's working in UIKit, SwiftUI, because I have also added property wrappers, the keychain storage property wrapper inside views, and the keychain publish inside observable objects. So let's dive right into it. I have prepared here a demo project. Let me just build and run so you can see what we actually have here. It's a tab view with free views, keychain vault view, and then the storage view, and then the published view. And about the code, I have created this labeled text field that it's just making my life easier with text fields and their values. And we have here a profile. Now, a keychain vault will save anything that is codable. That's why my example will be with CODABLE, but it's also storing strings, booleans, data types, whatever you can throw at it. So, and also the API is really, really well documented. Let's just jump right into it and take a look at the keychain vault view. Now, if I go back to my simulator, you will see that here we have the name text field, and whatever I type in here, it will be reflected on that label. And then we have keys, set, get, delete, and clear. Now, for the keys, we are going to fetch and just print out the keys that we have inside our keychain. Let's just do that really quickly. Well, before we do that, let's just add keychain vault to our project. Make sure that create groups is checked, copy item if needed is checked, and keychain vault target is selected. Okay, so now we can access keychain vault. So how can we grab our keys, the list of our keys? Well, we just print them out with keychain vault dot all keys. And that's just it. Now, currently we don't have any, so let's just build and run so you can see that empty array printed out in the log right over here. So let's see that. If I just have key, you can see it's just printing it out. Let's just set a key value pair right now. And what I have already prepared here is the profile is just linked to the text field, its name property. So everything is a throwing function. As you can see here, we have a do catch statement. So when we are setting a value, we are going to get back if it has properly set that value or not. And if it's not, then we are going to get an error thrown. So that's why I'm just going to say, well, let's just try and keychain vault dot set. So here we have it. We have set a value with a key and options. Now, let's just talk a bit about this one. And I'm just going to expand on this. You can see that we have with a string, boolean, and data. So also decodable and encodable, which is, of course, codable. Now, let's just use this one for now. And we are going to actually set the profile. And of course, because the text field is linked, binded to the profile's name, it's just going to use that profile when we are setting it. Now, about the key, let's just use vault key right over here. And the options. Now, this is really, really powerful. If you are not going to use the options, then it will just choose the default values. Now we have key prefix, access, access group, and synchronizable. Now, key prefix, you can use it for testing purposes when you are going to write tests. Access is whenever you want this to be available for setting, meaning that you can set, let's say, when the app is opened, or you can ask for Face ID lock. It's really, really nice. Access group, whenever you want to share this Keychain vault with other applications, you know, with different bundle IDs. Synchronizable, that is if you want to synchronize all of this data to iCloud, so you may access this data on another device, logged in, of course, to the same Apple ID. So I'm just going to use the default values right over here. It's perfectly fine. And yeah, as you can see, this is all we need to do. So let's hit Command R and let's see how this looks like. So I'm just going to type in here Ada, and then we are going to set it. Of course, now we don't see anything that, okay, it has been set. I'm going to fix that in just a second. For now, let's just grab our keys. And as you can see, the vault key has been added. So how to get notified when this profile has been set into Keychain? Well, we just have let success equals, we're going to get back a Boolean value. By the way, this is a discardable result function, therefore you might want to use allocated to a value or not. So let's just print out saved and then the success value. Let's build and run one more time. And yeah, we can't get for now, so I'm just going to add in here Ada one more time and just set it. And as you can see, save equals to true. Next up, we are going to get our values for that key. And it's right over here. It's as easy as just, again, a throwing function. Just go profile equals, and now that we have our type, it will infer it. It's really, really nice. Try Keychain vault, of course, again, Keychain vault dot get, and we have booleans, data, string values. I'm just going to have, let me just copy out the actual key so I will not mistype it. And that's just it. We are now having that converted into the profile. Of course, if this would be a string, it would just get that string. So let's get, and of course, the profile is going to update our label text field, which is really, really nice. Okay, let's just set Ada 2, let's just set that, and let's just delete the actual values of our text field, and let's get that again, and now we have Ada 2. And by the way, let me just build and run again so we can get that Ada 2. Let's get it, there we go. I don't really like that, so let's set it again, and let's close this. So now we want to delete it. What we can do after deletion is just set back the profile state variable to its initial value, which is the profile. Okay, so how can we delete? It couldn't be easier. Again, we just go try keychain vault dot and delete the key. Again, if you are setting this up when you are having set with options, then you just want to choose some options also, or maybe you're just going to use the default values. So again, let's paste the key right over there. As you can see, it's really, really nice API. Let's get that and let's delete. Of course, just going to remove that. And now if I try to get, you will get this thrown error. And this error code basically means that it could not find the item. Okay, so that's getting, but we also want to clear, one key value pair, but we also might want to delete all of the key value pairs from this keychain. So what we can do is just go try and keychain vault dot clear, as simple as that. Let's build and run, and let's see that. So first of all, I do need to set some values. So Ada, Okay, let's set that. And now let's take a look at the keys. As you can see, it's, there we have it. And then we just clear everything out. Okay, now let's grab the keys and maybe even have the get one. It's working as expected. And basically that's how you do handle keychain vault imperatively. But as you saw at the beginning of the video, we already also have SwiftUI declarative way of handling data. And that can be done in two ways. The first one is on the view. The second one is in the view model, in the observable object. Let's tackle the view first, because this is, again, so, so easy. So what we have here is just a form, and we are going to have another profile now stored at a different key. So let's just have it's a property wrapper, key chain storage. And we want to set its key. So let's have maybe storage key right over there, and private var profile. And let's give it a default, well, a starter value. So profile, there we go. You can see the API is quite like app storage, but now it's in keychain. So we have that, and now let's just bind this to our form, labeled text field with the title of name, and let's just bind $profile.name. Again, the binding is, you would expect it to be inside a SwiftUI project. So let's build and run. And by the way, this will automatically update itself. So let's go into the keychain storage tab view. And now let's just add in here Bob. And that's automatically saved into keychain. Let's just build and run again. And let's see it. We have it. There we go. We have Bob enabled there. That's simple as that. And it should be this simple. Now, what if you don't really like storing this stuff on the view? Maybe you have your view model and you are doing some work there. You want to get access and there on the view model also. So here is my view where I have a view model, an observable object. So what do we do? Well, again, keychain, but now not keychain storage, we are going to use keychain published, and it goes the same. So now we are going to have a key, so published key. Yeah, it has to be different because, you know, different tab views, and then var profile equals profile, as you would normally set up a published variable inside the observable object. Now we do have access to that profile through the view model in our view. So again, let's create our labeled text field, title, name, and then let's just bind it dollar sign view model dot profile dot name. And that's all you have to do. Let's build and run one final time. And let's see, let's add in here Claire. Clear. There we go. Here we have Bob. Also, let's just add in here Ada, and let's set it. And now let's take a look at the keys. As you can see, we have the storage key, published key, and vault key. Let's stop this, and for the final time, let's build and run, and let's see if we have those saved in keychain. Let's get the values. Ada, okay. Bob is here also, and Claire is there. And finally, I want to clear everything. Let's double check. Well, it is going to persist it, so let's double check on the keys. We don't have any keys, so let's build and run. And now you will see that there are no profiles set, which is really, really amazing. Now, why didn't it remove it from those the second and the third tab view? Well, that's because we have that in the memory right over here inside the observable object. Once we clear, we want to remove it, all of those values like we did on this line right over there. So just so you know. Now, If you do like Keychain Vault, go ahead and check it out. It's at store.rebeloper.com/keychain-vault. I believe this is a really amazing way to interact with Keychain. And if you want to find out how you can set the user location in SwiftUI's map, go ahead and check out the video. It's right over here.